Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to lecture number 9 of this engineering drawing and graphics course. And in today's lecture our objectives are to cover the nomenclature that is related to the shaft and the hole assembly, and what are the two systems, the shaft basis system and the hole basis system. What is the difference between these two and when will we use each of them? So at the end, we will talk about these two standards that are used for assigning tolerances to shaft and holes. So basically we covered type of fits in the last lecture, and today we are going to see the different standards that are related to formation of that fits and what are the basis behind these fits. So before doing that, let's discuss something that we missed in the previous lectures, and we talked about assemblies in the lecture of threads and fasteners. So in that assembly we discussed mechanical assemblies, and we said that mechanical assemblies are used to generate a type of desired motion. So we discussed some examples. One was the engine. So you are all familiar with the engines, but I missed the actual example of gear trains, linkages and actuators. So what are these? If you look at this diagram, this is basically these are basically linkages and example of linkages. And what is this linkage doing? This linkage is providing converting rotatory motion. For example, if this is this is a disc, if this disc is rotating, a rotating disc. So this is a rotating disc, and what we have done, we have translated this rotary motion into linear motion. And how are we doing this? We are doing this with the help of these two linkages. Here you can see that this disc is moving in a circle in a rotary formation, and this right here, if you would like to call this cylinder, let's say this cylinder is moving in a linear formation. So this conversion of motion is possible with the help of these linkages. So this is an actual example of a linkage. Similarly, what are gear trains? Gear trains are basically a connection of gears in different formations. This right here is a simple gear train that can you that you can see normally in engines. So this is a gear train in which gears are connected in a certain formation to exploit the rotation of one gear so onto another. Then what are actuators? Actuators are basically mechanisms that are used to provide a certain type of motion. So actuators are used for motion. They are used to provide motion, basically to provide motion, and that motion is very critical because it helps us to perform a certain function. So this is an example of a single cylinder rack and pinion. Rack and pinion is basically a gear in which there is also a rotary gear. This is a rotary gear, and this is the pinion, the rack. This is the rack which moves to and fro. So this is also an actuator. Basically the pinion moves in this direction in this direction, and it moves the rack. This is the rack, either in this direction or in this direction. So this is an example of a rack and pinion actuator. And basically what is this actuator doing? This actuator is providing this cylinder, this piston right here. This piston right here and right here too, it is moving this piston to and fro. This rack and pinion actuator is basically moving the piston to and fro. So these are the actual examples of a gear train, linkages and actuators and their mechanisms that you can actually see. So today what we are going to do, we are going to take this basic shaft and hole assembly. This is a shaft and this is a hole, and we are going to derive a system in the shaft basis system, the hole basis system, and we are going to see the different type of fits that can be possible between these two shaft and hole, and the standards that are used to define the sizing of the shaft relative to the hole, or the sizing of a hole relative to the shaft. So this will be our basis, a shaft and a hole assembly for all the type of fits that we are going to discuss, both in the English standard and in the metric standard. So let's do that. And yes, one thing, this figure is from Engineering Graphics Essentials, the 5th edition, that is the book, our textbook, and it is by Christian Plettenberg. We are following two books here. One was our drawing textbook, and this is another book that I will recommend for you to follow for this topic. And I will also mention other books when we meet in our online session. So the system of limits and fits that was based on the shaft and the hole assembly are of two types. One is a hole based system and the other is a shaft based system. So what is the difference between the two? In a hole based system, what we do, actually we are talking about the assembly of a hole and a shaft. So in a hole based system, what we are going to do, we will keep the diameter of the hole constant and the shaft diameter will vary. And it is economical because we will be using a single hole, we will be doing just a single drill to make that hole, and then we will vary the diameter of the shaft to fit them into a desired fit. Then, as you can see in this diagram, the hole diameter is constant, this is the hole, and the shaft diameter is changing, as you can see. So this it is a hole based system, and there are also three types. In the clearance type, as you can see, the clearance type, the shaft diameter is less than the basic size of the hole, so there will be clearance in between them. And then in transition, right here in transition, the hole is not completely the hole is not completely large than the shaft, and they are basically both in interference and clearance fit. So this is transition fit, and then in interference fit, the shaft dia is very large than the hole diameter. So this is the hole based system in which the hole diameter is constant, and we will vary the size of a shaft to fit them both together. Then the shaft based system, and as you know, the hole diameter will vary in this case, and the shaft diameter will be constant, and we will assign various sizes to the hole to fit them both together. And this tends to be costly, as more than one drill is required. In this case, only one drill was required, and in this case more than one drill will be required. So this is the shaft based system in which the shaft diameter is constant, as you see now, and we are varying the diameter of the hole for the clearance, transition and interference fit. So in shaft based system, as it is written here, this text is taken from the Plettenberg book. So the shaft size and limits are maintained constant, and the limits are hold are varied. So this system is generally used in industry where the shaft is important. I've added this text for this line because when will we use a shaft based system? We will use it where the shaft is important. For example, if the shaft is going to be used for carrying load, then that shaft is important. So we will not like that shaft to be machined, because machining it will actually remove material from it, and it will add stresses to that shaft, and it will weaken that shaft. One can be this reason. So as you can see, this is a propeller shaft. This is a propeller shaft to which a propeller is attached. And you can see that the engine is actually transferring power to this shaft, and then this shaft is transferring power to this propeller, and this propeller is rotated, and this ship will move in this direction. So here the shaft is important, the strength of the shaft is important. So we will keep its diameter constant, and we will vary the hole size that is required to be fitted onto here on different places. So This is also another type of shaft on which gears are attached. You can see the keyways that is used to attach the gears on this shaft. So this is also a stepper shaft. Then the whole basis system is commonly used because it is cheap. The whole basis system is cheap, so that's why it is very commonly used, because it is easy to make a hole by using different drills, tabs, reamers and branches that are of the that are categorized according to their sizes, and they are available for producing holes, and their sizes are not adjustable. You do not need to adjust the size of different drill tabs and reamers. They are already available in their adjusted sizes, so you can just directly use them in the drill bit or in the drill machine to make a hole. And on the other hand, the size of the shaft produced by turning and grinding etc. will prove to be costly. For example, this shaft will require machining for different diameters, so you will have to adjust the machine again and again. So this will incur a lot of machining cost and time and energy, while a certain size of a hole will just require that size of a drill bit. If we have them, so we will require that size of a drill bit and to make that hole. So that's why making a hole is easier than adjusting the size on a shaft. So as we discussed, the basic hole system is used when the basic size is attached to the hole dimension, and the basic shaft system is used when the basic size is attached to the basic shaft dimension. And again, if you want to tolerance a shaft based on a hole produced by a standard drill, reamer, broach or another standard tool, so they are standard. These tools are standard, so you will just use the size of tool for which a size of hole is required. So for example, if you want tolerance to be a hole based on the size, purchased a standard drill rod. So that can be for a basic shaft system. For example, this statement will hold true. So now we are going to discuss the two standards that are required to assemble a shaft and a hole according to different type of fits. So the first system is the ANSI standard, that is also known as the English standard, and this text is again taken from the Plettenberg book. And there are three types that are classified in the English standard. One is the running and the clearance fits, this is also known as the RC fit. Then the locational fits. Locational fits are again of three types: locational clearance, locational transition and interference fits. And then the third type is the force fits, and again force fits are of five types, from FN1 to FN5. So the running and the clearance fit have also types: RC1, RC2, RC3, and in the coming slides we will see that from here we can actually see the designated sizes of these three types of fits. So in from the name, as you can see, running and sliding clearance will allow a certain amount of motion. Locational fits will allow or not allow a certain type of motion. It can also be used for fastening as well. And the force fits are used for fastening, for permanent or temporary fastening. So now let's see that from here we will see their values. So as you can see, the class of fits, that is for running and sliding clearance fits, these are the classes, different classes: RC1, RC2, RC3, RC4, RC5, RC7, 9, 8. So they are closed sliding fits, in which the clearance is not that much. Then it is sliding fit, where there will be a certain amount of clearance. Then precision running fits, where the precision is required. Close running fits, medium running fits, free running fits and loose running fits. You can see the design use. For example, the loose running fits are used with such materials such as cold rolled shafting, tubing, mat to commercial tolerances. Or if you can read the statement for close sliding fits, then we can see that they are used for accurate location of parts that must be assembled without precipital play. So you do not want them to move. For example, you do not want such type of fits to move. You want them to fit just right there and do not move. For example, a bearing and a shaft assembly. and sliding fit are used for accurate location. Parts will move and turn easily but are not intended to run freely. Parts may be messy with small changes in temperature. So such fits can seize motion with changes in temperature. And you can also read the design uses for these type of fits too. Then these are the classes for the locational fits classes, the locational clearance fit, the locational transition fits, and the locational interference fits and their particular design uses. Similarly, the force fit classes, the FN1, FN2, FN3, FN4 and 5. So these are the different classes for the three types of fits that we read in the English system. So these are the different type of tables. These are the tables for a basic hole system in which the basic size is assigned to a hole. And here this is for the running and the sliding clearance fits, the RC fits. And these are the different type of sizes that are designated to various basic sizes. For example, if your basic size is between 0 and 0.12, then for them the class RC1 size for hole and shaft are given, the upper and lower limit. Similarly for RC2, RC3 and RC4, the hole size and the shaft sizes are given for the different type of fits for the running and the sliding clearance fits. So for that purpose, we will be referring to the tables to see their sizing. Similarly, there are tables for locational and clearance fits, the LC fits, the LC1, LC2, LC3, LC4 and correspondingly, their values are tabulated according to the basic, the range of the basic sizes that can vary according to this table. And for those sizes, for those basic sizes, we can actually read different values for the hole and the shaft. And similarly, for location transition fits, we have also a table. And at last, the force and shrink fits, that they can also be read from the table, the FN1, FN2, FN3, FN4 and the FN5 class according to their basic sizes, a range of basic sizes given for which the different sizes of the hole and shafts are given. And as you can see, all these tables were for a basic hole system. So for each value, for example, FN1, there is only one size of a hole. That is 0.25. Only one size dimension is given for a hole, and then two size dimensions are given for a shaft. So you can actually see that the hole dimension is fixed and the shaft dimensioning is varying. So then the other standard is the metric tolerance standard, and in this standard we have some basic terminologies to cover, and for that purpose we have listed this diagram and the different definitions that is used in this diagram. And first of all is the upper deviation. The upper deviation is the difference between the maximum size limit and the basic size. So the maximum size limit of a shaft and the basic size, this is the basic size for the shaft. And similarly, if you find this for upper deviation for the hole, so it will be the difference between the maximum size and the basic size. And similarly, the lower deviation, the difference between the minimum size limit and the basic size. Fundamental deviation is the deviation closest to the basic size. So this right here is the fundamental deviation. So this deviation is the closest to the basic size deviation. This is closest by most amount of this size. So the letter H represents the fundamental deviation for hole. So H alphabet will be used for hole deviation, and the letter F indicates the fundamental deviation for the shaft in this figure right here. In this figure right here, H will always be used for a hole, while for shaft the alphabet can change. It will change. So we will see that in the coming slides. So letter F will be here is used for a shaft tolerance zone, and H is used for the hole tolerance zone. And these are basically the fundamental deviations. The fundamental deviation contains a letter H for hole and an alphabet F for shaft. And then it has another digit, that is 8. This is the IT number. This is the international tolerance grade. This IT numbers actually gives us the different machining options that can be used for attaining a certain type of tolerance that is required. We will see its table in the next slide. And for example, this 7 represents the IT number that can be used. The IT number is basically for the machining process. The machining process that can be used to attain a certain amount of tolerance. So these are all the terminologies that are listed here. And then the tolerance zone, the gray zone right here is the tolerance zone. As you can see, this is the tolerance zone. So let's move forward. Then the tolerance is a designation for metric system contains these things. The fits are specified by using the fundamental deviation letter and the IT international tolerance grade. So this is the fundamental deviation letter and the international tolerance grade for hole, and this is the fundamental deviation and international tolerance grade for the shaft. This is the basic size that is given. And when specifying the fit, uppercase, the for the hole, the uppercase letter is used. For example, H is uppercase letter, capital letter, and for the shaft, the lower case letter, that is F, is used. For example, F is right here is the small letter, that is the lower case letter. These are the IT grades, and IT grades, for example, IT grade 4 means that we will be able, with this machining operation, we will be able to achieve close tolerances. For IT grade 4 and 5, we should use lapping and honing. And similarly for RP grade 5, 6, 7, we should use cylindrical grinding. For IP grade 5, 6, 7, 8, we can use surface grinding. So these are basically all the machining operations that are mentioned according to their IT grades. And the larger the IT grades, the less will be the tolerance that will be we will be able to achieve. But with high low IT grades number, for example IT4, the lapping and honing are actually very low material removing operations. They remove material very in small layers. They remove material in small layers. So with the help of lapping and honing, we will be able to achieve close tolerances. But for example, die casting or punching or drilling, they actually remove very high material, means they remove more material from your part. And with these IT grades, you will not be able to achieve close tolerances. So these are the IT grades that define the different machining operations for which we can achieve our desired tolerances. So this is the diagram for the hole basis system, and as you can see, all the blue columns right here, all the blue columns right here are designated with a capital letter H, and their size is not changing. And here the shaft basis, the pink color is used for the shaft basis, the shaft tolerance, and here the shaft tolerance is changing because this is a basic hole system. As you can see, for a hole tolerance only a capital letter H is used, and for a shaft tolerance the alphabets are changing from C, D, F, G, H, K, N, P, S, U. So these are the alphabets for the shaft tolerances, and they are changing here. Their sizing is changing because this is a hole basic system for which the hole tolerance is constant and the shaft tolerance is changing. And you can see, if you use H11 and C11, and then you will have a clearance between your hole and a shaft. And similarly, correspondingly, this region for these combinations, these will be the clearance fits, and for these combinations of hole and shaft sizes, these will be the transition fits, and for these combinations of hole and shaft sizes, these will be the interference fits. So this is a diagram for the hole basis system. Then we have a also similar diagram for a shaft basis system, and now the shaft tolerance is constant, as you can see right here, and the hole tolerances are changing. So again, the three regions of fits are defined for clearance fits, transition fits, and interference fits. The ranges are given according to which we can select any combination for our design. So these are the tables from which we can read the different sizing for our hole and shaft, and this is determined by the basic size. So first we need to have the basic size, so right here it is 40. Then if we use this combination for loose running fit, then we will have H11, C11. So H is the fundamental deviation and 11 is the IT grade. You see that the larger the IT grade number, the course will be the tolerances, and the finer the IT number, the smaller will be the tolerances. So these are the loose running, free running, close running, sliding and locational clearances, and these are for the metric tolerance grade. This table is for metric tolerancing, and from here you can see different tolerances assigned to a hole and a shaft on the basis of their basic size and the on the basis of their fits, the type of fits, if it is loose running, close running, or it is a locational clearance fit. Then what are their descriptions? For example, if you use them H11, C11, C11 or H11 based on the hole basis or shaft basis. So for loose running fit, for wide commercial tolerances or allowance on the external member. So these are the clearance fits and the different type of clearance fits and their design application. Their design application are given. So you can read them yourself. Transition fits and interference fits are also given, and correspondingly their design applications are also given. So again, I have just put these slides so that you can see the actual uses of the different type of fits that we just discussed. These are the clearance fits, and you can correspondingly see the different type of fits. Basically, they are all some are hole basis, some are shaft basis. Where you see capital H, they are hole basis, and if you see a letter other than capital H, for example, capital G, is this right here is now a shaft basis system, and these two are right here a hole basis system. Similarly, there this is also a hole basis system. So their description is given and their practical uses are given. For example, if we see the clearance fits right here, these are the fits between which there is a lot of clearance, fits with great clearance, with parts having great tolerances. So their actual examples are pivot, latches, fits of parts exposed to corrosive effects, contamination with dust, and thermal or mechanical deformation. So kindly see these examples by yourself, Google them, see their images, that what type of fits they are talking about, what are the regular bearings, the general fits of shafts, regular bearings, machine, tool spindles, sliding tool rods. Kindly see these examples by yourself, see the videos on the YouTube, and see that what type of fits are they talking about. Similarly, there are some other type of clearance fits, the hubs and the clutch disc, bearing bushes, similarly permanent couplings and couplings and gears with shaft and flanges. Kindly see their examples from internet. Similarly, some other type of clearance. So these are the different examples of a different type of fits, and you can actually see from the type of hole system or shaft system that is being used, their actual description, that what is their description. For example, if you read that out, press fits with guaranteed interference. So these fits will have interference. There will be no clearance. Assembly of parts can be carried out to use cold pressing. So these are the type of your actual uses, hubs of clutches and disc bearing bushes. So kindly go to the internet, see these examples by yourself, see their images, their videos, you will find plenty on the YouTube, and then you will get the idea of what type of fits they are talking about and how they are related to actual real life examples that are being used. And they are all mechanical examples. There are very good mechanical examples that you will be seeing in your department as well, and in the future if you go to the industry as well.